Mayong adlong lunes, no? And we have a new topic to share to you, no? So we have the topic on simple string, no? Now suppose you have a figure, no? This is the body. So first, no? Wala siya load gibutang. So it's means kini this is the original length, no? So without any load being imposed into the body, this is the cross-sectional area. Okay, of the this is the section of your body, and if ever there is a force being applied into the body, so some many kinds of force when that is perpendicular to the resisting area, so kining a force will actually create a tensile force, no? There is atom body, so as an effect of the tensile force, no? So the body will actually elongate, no? So possibly siya mo produce o elongation. If that's compression, so possibly siya mo produce o kung sa compression or a shortening of the body. Now, the change in length is what is termed as the deformation, this one. Now, so, what is defined as a strain? Now, so, strain is actually defined as the ratio between the deformation over the original length. Now, so, ini day. And strain is denoted with the symbol. Now, so, this is a lowercase epsilon, no? And that is also equal to the lowercase delta, no? Over the original length. So, strain di ay is a unit deformation. Ang stress o samantong stress, it is the unit strength of the material. And strain, that is a unit deformation, which is a ratio of the deformation over the original length. So, if you have to consider the units involved, no, for the strain, since ang atong deformation is expressed in terms of a unit in length, no, so panalita mo itong meter, ang L sa demometer. So, ang atong unit sa deformation can be equal to sa meter per meter. Or it could be, mahimusag may ngon ka nga, millimeter per sa millimeter. So, if that is millimeter ang numerator, denominator is also millimeter, so it would be the same ang ato deng strain is actually a unitless quantity. Pero sa ibutang na siya, meter per meter, inch per inch, no? So that's the unit and strain. So or mahimo ra gyud pod nga di na lang imong butangan og unit. Okay? Now, how to gather the relationships between stress and strain, no? So ang imong buhaton ana. So, there is actually a machine, no, which can be used, no, to for us to identify the stress and the strain, no, so yung ini. There is what is termed as a universal testing machine, no, or a UTM, no. So, morning nga nagbarog, no, kung analog ka type, so muna imuhang makita, no. So, ang imuhang panalitan, ato'y subject into a tinsel test, no? Ang imuhang steel ball, no? So, arin na ibutang dire, you have to consider a gauge length, no? So, you have to grip both ends and gradually, the load will be applied. So, kuhaan saan na sa length when there is no load yet, no? Then, little by little, ang imuha garong load, imong e-saka. And upon changing the load, imusang kuhaon on-say change in length, no? Which is the deformation. No, so doon natin analog na sa ingon na ang mga purma, no? So pwede na nato ma-record over the computer, no, kung unsa yung mga changes in length, no, so the load, no, so appeal na diha, no, so ingon na ang atong universal testing machine, no, so naana pang lili mo diha sa CE department, so naa mo yung makita nga UTM. Okay, ingon na. Now, in order for us to determine the relationships between stress and strain, so pwede na maghimo og diagram. Okay, ngayon. So, we have the stress-strain diagram. Horizontally, ang atong horizontal, mo'y mo record sa deformation. Ang vertical, mo'y mo record sa oran na ito ibutang ang atong sa ang atong load. Pero ang atong load, not exactly load mo itong ibutang, but it should be stress. So, it is P over the cross-sectional area. Well, here, ang may na-adere sa horizontal, nadhay mong strain, which is a ratio between unsa deformation over the original length. Now, gradually increasing the load, no? Ingani. Then, there is also a corresponding strain, no? So, and you notice that from O to a certain point P, you will notice that the graph is actually linear. So, that means there is a direct proportionality. But when you reach this point, actually, kaning mga point imong nakita diha, wala magpasabot nga dunay discontinuity of your curve, no? So that is just to emphasize that we have points along your curve, no? Or within your curve, nga atong gusto ipakita. But actually, kana that is continuous, connected na dyan. Now, pag-abot ni mong point P, ang ato akarong line supposed to be from O to P, so you form a straight line, that means there is a direct proportionality, that means, gikan sa O to P, ang imong slope is constant. Okay? Pero paglampas ni mo, ano, purma naman kang curve, no? So, dili na siya linya atong mapurma, dili na line. So, meaning, kung sa slope diha, dili na na maodir eh. Okay? So, this point, after P, atong tawagon og elastic limit, no? So, we have the elastic limit. So, sabi mo na nan, if we have to mention the term elastic. Okay? Then, another point beyond the elastic limit is the yield point. And you will notice in the yield point, ang ato karong curving ane, no? Mo sa na platin gamay. So kung mo platin, meaning wala increase in load, but there is a further increase in the deformation. And if there is a further increase in deformation, so it would also mean that there is also a further increase in strain. So not necessarily be nga doon na increase in the load dere after what point? The yield point. But later, unahan, oh, naginahanglan na siya gag-load. Until maabot siya o kinataasan nga load, no, nga mo produce og stress diha. So this is the highest ordinate, no, of your curve, which defines your ultimate strength, no. So musaka na siya, pero being the ultimate na, so pag-abot na sa unahan, so maginahanglan siya lesser load niya, pero the deformation will still take place until beyond the ultimate. So doon na nag point at which munsa doon na na'y breaking or doon na na'y rupture, no? So, but na'y makita ni mo doon na'y dotted line diha, no? Anya, ang imong point dire, gitawag sa natong actual rupture strength, rupture strength. So, why is it that it is found above this point here? It is because ang imong actual rupture strength ko, no? Dili yun ni imong makuha dire. Gagiyon sa manin mo pagkuha sa imong stress dire, it is just force over the original area. But when you keep on increasing the load, no? Then, manotice nimo nga dunay deformation. So, kung dunay deformation, kanang imong rebar or imong steel bar, maghinay-hinay nag-nicking, no? Pareho yung ining interval. Gikan sa unsa? Gikan sa Y to point O, asam na U, dira? Gikan sa Y, asam na yung Y, dira? Paingon sa U. So, sa ato pa, dunay deformation imong makita, no? So, if you continue increasing the load, no? So, the deformation will also increase. And what have you noticed with the section of your bar? Ang imong section sa bar mag-produce og nicking. So, ari din mo develop og weak points wherein later, when you reach the point R, so, ano na diha mo break imuhang material. So, if we initially define our stress as force over area dere, so, ang imong area magagamay. So, kung ang imong area magagamay, force over area, the stress is actually becoming very, very large. So, kini siya, ang imong larger value sa imong stress, sumuning na adere. Pero kini, ang imong force over the original area raman, sumunang, ang imong stress, murag ni gamay. Pero dire, kung imo din kuhaon kining area sa section nga muputol na siya, so sa ato pa, ang imong stress ana magadako. Kaya ang imong denominator dire, mugamay gani ang sa ubos, sa ato pa mudako ni. Gamay ubos, dako mo na imong hinumduman, pero dako ang ubos, magamay ang value sa entire fraction. Now, ingin ni bitaw na. So, magagamay ang imong section dere, so makaproduce siya more, greater value sa imong stress. Muna kung imong i-graph, ang imong diagram, ato giday ang point sa above, no? Muna yung kag-actual. Pero kini, gibase na to on the original section of our bar, no? So, daghantag mga point karon diha nga nakita. So, dire, makita ni mo nga doon ay deformation. So, doon na siya yun sa. Doon ay deformation mo take place o imong i-release imong load. Ana. So, posible nga dili na nakabalik o gingon ini. Kaya doon naman tayo gitawag o elastic. Usam na elastic. Ang elastic, ana, kung pwede pa, modiform, pero pwede pa siya kabalik sa iyang original shape. Pero, if there's a point somewhere here beyond the elastic limit, so, ang ato karong body, modibilap o deformation wherein if the load will be released, ang ato karong sa. Ang ato karong body, dili na kagubak into its original shape. No? So, there is a permanent set or there is a permanent deformation. Labi nag-ari na dire. No? So, asa man to, unahan sa asa? Unahan sa elastic limit. So, modiform na na siya. Nga, doon na siya deformation. Yeah, ang body, ana, dili na kagubak even if cannot go back to its original ship, original length, even if the load will be released. No? So we have different points at ni ilahon sila tanan, P, the proportional limit, the elastic limit, the yield point, ultimate strength, the rupture strength, and the actual rupture strength. So ato na ning na-explain nga nung dunay point dere, because the area is actually becoming smaller when there is a bigger load and your body is about to break. Okay? So we have the proportional limit. No? So sa itong proportional limit, the proportional limit can be found at what po interval from O to P. Okay, so yung ini. In the stress strain diagram, Sir Robert Hooke, no, in 1678 was first to notice that from O to P, the stress is directly proportional to strain. At proportional limit, it indicates the maximum stress that can be applied to the material where stress and strain are directly proportional. No? So, slope there is becoming constant. No? Or constant. So, ito sa proportional limit. In elastic limit, o sa may behavior sa atong body, that is a stress beyond which the material will not return to its original shape when the load is removed, but will retain a permanent deformation or a permanent set. So, kung imong tanan imong diagram, kung naapaka sa, mapakakaabot sa elastic limit, kung doon mo deform gan imong body, pareho kung elastic ko, no? O imong i-release, mabalik na siya to its original length, no? Pero, paglampas nimo sa elastic limit, mo na itong modiform siya, pero pag-release nimo, so dili na siya ka-totally go back into its original length. So, ganoon naman, doon na natin gitawag o permanent set that is beyond the elastic limit. Pero sa abot pa, gikan sa autopay, kung modiform man imong body, so mura-mura ra o kung sa action sa rubber band, so inig-release nimo sa imong load, mo-go back na siya to its original length. Now, another point after the elastic limit is the, kung saan ito? Yield point. Okay, sige ini. Ah, no. Doon na patay mga elastic ranges. So, kanang elastic ranges di atong tanawin. O, ang atong plastic ranges, no? So, ang elastic ranges, range, naa mag-range sa autopy. Okay, can you imagine? Do we need to go back to the diagram? Tanawin na lang, ha? Basta, gikan sa autopy, elastic range na siya. Kanong elastic range? Because the body can still go back to its original shape, original length, amen, no? So with no deformation, ngayon mo makita, even if na-deform siya when the load was applied, but when it is released, mabalik rapon siya sa iyang original length. Pero pag-abotin mo sa plastic range, no? Asa ang plastic range? Kandili na siya maka-go back to its original shape. So, gikan sa P to R. Actually, naaguna gikan sa asa. Gikan sa elastic din to R. So, P, napan is proportional. Pero, i-consider na siya as a plastic range. No? So, dili na siya kayo capable of going back to its original shape. So, gikan sa proportional to the rupture point. No? Okay? So, yung ini. Yield point. O sa to yield point? O sa to yung nakita ang behavior sa imong graph at the yield point? At the yield point, yung ini. A point at which the material will have an appreciable deformation or yielding without any increase in the load. Mo to imong makita mo platin ang curve, no? At ako doon tanaw balik, no? Bahalag malangan ta, dire. Kung imong tanaw dire, no? So at this point, no? Yeah, this is the yield point. So ang imong curve ana mo platin, no? Wala na sa ato pa nag-increase ang deformation, pero wala ra ka makinahanglan nga mo increase sa imong load. So naa na sa yield point. Sumurag nanalaw na ang imuhang nanalaw ang imuhang steel, ang imuhang material nga imong gitest, pero unahan na murag nakaamgo gamay, no? Ngano man ni sukol naman sa balik, ni barog naman sa, no? So ano nung padaog to na, so bitaw gibira, no? So yan ay load, no? O yan, nag-deform siya. So you need more load, no? So katapusan na lang po siguro dito pangisog niya, ngano man pag-abot dire, muna niya gitawag o ultimate strength, muna niya kina kusga niya nga kaya siya maka-resist og load, no? Because ana, pag-abot ana, so modiform na siya even if ang imong load mo, imong i-decrease. So, pag-abot ni mo sa ultimate, so it will continue to deform, no? Now, that is when you reach the ultimate strength, no? Pero, kung natong tanawin ito ganin ng mga terms, no? Naataan na sa yield, no? So, a yield is a point wherein there is an appreciable deformation or yielding without any increase in the load. No? So, that explain ano mo platin sa gamay, then musaka unahan. No? Then, after the yield point, doon na tayo sa Doon natay ultimate strength, no? So ang ultimate strength or in ultimate tensile strength, no? So it is the highest ordinate in the stress strain diagram. Muna na kinataasan niya ngon sa strength nga makari. So muna sa na kinataasan niya nga load nga makari. Okay? Rupture strength. Simple mo break na. So that is a point wherein your body will break, no? So that is the breaking strength. The stress at failure. Muna to siya mabuto. No, ilhan na nimo nga ligon nimo material, no? Kay madungog yun na nimo nga mubuto. So makadungog ka mubuto, ligon na siya, no? Di kay mubuto, no? Mulanay ra na, murarag kandila nga nalanay, no? Oh, so dili na siya ligon, no? Bisag magtest kag halo kanang kuan kanang halo block or unsa cylindrical sample, no? So makupog ra gina siya ginahinay, pero kung kuso ligon gani kay mo material, madungog gina nimo nga mo buto. So mo buto gani ka ligon ka, no? Oh, no, dili ikaw ang material, no? Okay, go. Modulus of resilience. In the modulus of resilience, actually that really refers to the work done on a unit volume of the material as the force is gradually increased from O to P. So gikan sa O to P, so the unit of which is Newton meter per cubic meter. Kay work done man, work, so Newton meter, this is a unit of work and this is a unit in volume. And how to calculate, kuhaon lang nimo ang area of your stress strain curve, no? Gikan sa O to P. So under which, no? So kung sa imong area makuha mo na imuhang modulus of resilience. Okay? So, term na, timan eh. So, from O to E. Then, the area of which will represent the modulus of resilience. No? Now, sa muning resilience property of the material. The resilience of a material is its ability to absorb energy without creating a permanent distortion. Murmura rago nagtao, no? Nga makasugat kag problema. So, paghuman anas problema, unahan ana, murmura niya. So, resilient kayo ka. No? So, pero magubain mong naong, unahan, maklaro na nga kagi kag problema, o ka na, dili ka resilient. So, maura sa ning materialist, no? Ang atong isubject into stress test, no? So, kung imo na siyang isubject into test, no? So, it is actually absorbing energy, no, without creating a permanent distortion. So, dili nimo manotice kay nganuan, pwede rin mag siya makabalik into its original length, original shape, no? So, may pagka-elastic pa siya dapit, no? So, ingat. Now, another term. Now, we also have the modulus of toughness. No, it is also referring to a work done, pero lahi na imong range. It is from 0 to sa 0 to R. Gani na asa to dapit. Atong range in the modulus of resilience, tanaw na to. In the modulus of resilience, it is from 0 to P. Pero kung adto na ka sa unsa, mo adto na ka sa modulus of toughness, it is from 0 to R. The area under your stress strain diagram, imong kuhaon, so muna imuhang modulus of toughness. Okay, so what is the property of material when we consider it as tough material? So, the material is tough. The toughness of the material is its ability to absorb energy without causing it to break. So, unsay nakalahi sa resilience? Sa resilience, so possibly mo deform, pero so man, makabalik ra siya, no? So di nimo manotice, mo absorb siya sa inyong energy. So then dere ang toughness, posible gyud siya na deform, pero dili lang gyud pud siya mo break. So that is considered as tough, no? So kusog mo taw kasugat og problema, dako nang problema. So kung tough na siya, bisan pag bunog na kay siya, di gyud siya mulayat sa fourth floor, no? Okay, so that's tough, no? Pero dali kayong mo break yang madali kayo mo break ang material, so that material is not considered as tough, no? Pero ang sa resilience, possibly mo deform, pero makabalik na siya. Dili na niya manote, dili na itong manotice nga nakasugat siya mga deformation. Pero dire, possibly nag-deform, pero dili gid siya mo break. Okay? So walay breakage. Dili siya mo, no break, dili siya, dili ni mo manotice ang breaking of the material. That's considered to be tough. Working stress, allowable stress, and the factor of safety. Working stress is the actual stress of the material when there's a load, no? Tangani mo load, no? Onya, mo na stress nga ma-build up. So, we call that as the working stress, no? Then, what is termed as the allowable stress? That is the stress that can be maximum stress for which the material can carry. cost value must not be exceeding the proportional limit. So ang imuha ding allowable stress naara na sa point P. So allowable stress mura na imo i-consider, mao na ito i-consider nga magdaog makaya sa imong material. Ayaw na itong unahan sa P, no? So dili na na kay i-consider sa design, no? Now dire ang ato ding allowable stress o working stress, ang atong working stress ari ra po nakuhaon sa atong allowable stress, no? Okay, so yun eh. Working stress is also considered as the allowable stress. Okay? Ang allowable stress as ito, gikan sa, so aton lang inon nga sa peak o tub, no? Okay, mo na allowable nga makari sa atong material, no? So dili na to exceed bian, ano, kung mag-design ka, diha lang sa kakutob sa allowable. Okay? Then, that's last term is the factor of safety. Okay, since proportional limit ko no is difficult to determine accurately, so mo itong atong gigraph ganina kay may ta line then point, you have the proportional limit pero dili tanan nga material ingon ana ka sayon pagpangita sa mga point, no? So ang ato kunong proportional limit dili makita ka sayon ingon ana. Now tanaw ra gud no atong diagram ganina, atong balikan ha. Sa atong diagram ganina, okay ngini. Ako na akong gidiagram, straight line, then we have the different points involved, then maingon na. Pero kini, una yan, oh. So, ano ka kayo, asa dapit ang proportional limit? Wala yung mausay gani ka ng yield point, listo na pangitaon. So, naitiknik pag was yield point, maghimo lang ka diha o line, that is tangent in eh. Tangent sa imong curve diri sa O, kung imo ng padaganan, niya, mag-opsit ka. So, maguha ka line that's parallel sa imuhang kato imong i-construct ganina nga tangent dire. Then, allow that to intersect with your curve. That point will be assumed as the location of your yield point. That's a technique on how to get the yield point if ang imong result dire dili kay nimo makita asa ni silang mga point. No? So, imo nang kuhaon. Yield point. So, kung na yield point, wala pa ito proportional limit na na. Or maybe ka ng ultimate. Kaya ng ultimate mo naman yung kintasan ng value. So, malukit sa na siya. Now, ang atong factor of safety. So, kung do you have a difficulty of locating the proportional limit? So, ari nimo ibase sa yield or sa ultimate, no? So, ang yield, makuha nimo by just katagong ingon, mag-opsit ka by 0.2%, no? Maghuha ka 0.2% offset. So, imong butangag line, nga parallel atong line, nga imong i-draw tangent diri. No? Then, imo gani na siyang i-project until mo intersect sa curve. So, gana nga point. Muna na imong tawagon o yield point. Now, in our factor of safety, saan naman itong factor of safety? So, since kuno proportional limit is difficult to determine accurately, the allowable stress is taken either at the yield point. Mati ko kayo ngayon, so pwede ito nimo ilocate ang yield point, or if not, ato ka sa ultimate strength, you divide it with a number, and that number is what is termed as the factor of safety. Okay? So, yung ganyan. In most observation ko no, many materials have proportional limit half of the ultimate strength. So kung nakakuha ka o ultimate strength, imo lang nang i-divide og to, muna yung proportional limit no, most of the material. But to avoid accidental overloading, a working stress, ang working stress of one half of the proportional limit, ang imo karong half pagyadana, half of that, imong i-consider daan as the dead load. No, sa manang dead load. Nga kargahan itong patay ang dead load like the weight of the member itself or any load that is imposed permanently imposed into the body into the structure we consider that as a dead load. Now in a factor of safety kung atong ibase sa ultimate na no? Ultimate strength na no? So imo lang i-divide with the allowable kaya ang allowable is equal to ultimate strength na no? Divided by the factor of safety and just the same kung ang imong gamiton is the yield point, no? Kung ang yield point mo imong gamiton over the allowable because the allowable is yield over the factor of safety. Okay? Yes, working stress or allowable stress which is kanina, imong gunang ibalhin rin sa denominator, so ultimate stress over factor of safety, yield stress over the factor of safety. Okay? A working stress set in this way corresponds to a factor of safety of 4 for materials with quite uniform and homogeneous. But for other material with lots of deformities, no, like wood, no, unpredicted, unpredicted like not holes for wounds, larger factors are considered. So, pwede ko na ka magamit og 4 as a factor of safety, pero kung daghan og mga deformities imuhang body nga gigamit, no? So, you can have a higher value, higher than 4, no? So, ang 4 may itong limit, but you can increase, no? For the value of the factor of safety. Aside from that, you also have to consider the stiffness in the design, no? Not only the strength of the material, no? So, the strength, no? Okay, so, it is the ratio of the steady force acting on the elastic body to the resulting displacement. So, this is actually defining the stiffness key. Now, what is the restriction of Hooke's law? If you have to apply the Hooke's law. By the way, sa tanong Hooke's law? Actually, higit ka na ni katong si Robert Hooke nga nagunsa, naka-observe sa direct proportionality relations between stress and strain from O to P. Now, una, kinapat ko na ang load is axial. It could be tensile or it could be unsa, compressive loads, no? Or compressive load, no? Atong i-apply into the body. Bar must have a constant cross-section and it must be made uniform. So, ang imong cross-section must be constant, uniform, no? Pod, ang imong section. Stress must not be exceeding the proportional limit. So, that is the limitation of your Hooke's law. Now, from Hooke's law, applied to axial deformation, so we notice that our stress is directly proportional to strain. No? If that is directly proportional to strain, no? Yeah, atong butang equality symbol, so we can introduce the constant of proportionality E. So, but kung ato usang stress, kaya ba lumantang P over E, niya, usan siya? Strain is deformation over the original length, so pwede na ko nilisan. I can replace my stress with P over A and my strain with the formula for strain. Okay? So, actually, what I need to arrive is the deformation formula. Okay? So, kung imo nang i-simplify nara, kung imo nang i-solve ato ang delta, the deformation, lowercase delta, no? So, it would be P as a denominator. So, associated with P ang L, no? So, ang atong unsa, ang atong denominator nga E will be multiplied also with E. Okay, so this is the axial deformation. The unit there may be in meter, may be in inches, may be in feet, or in equivalent unit. No? Now, your P is the axial load in Newton. Your L is the original length, may be in meter. The cross-sectional area can be in square meter. Actually, ang E, unsa ito ng E? E is the constant of proportionality, which is also termed as the modulus of elasticity. Okay, what is E? That is the modulus of elasticity, which defines the slope of your line from O to P. Okay? So, we have the modulus of elasticity, or we term that as Young. Young modulus. No? So, the other term for modulus of elasticity is Young modulus. So, we have the first formula, or we have the formula we obtain, no? Gine? Aside from this, kadto sang stiffness, no? K. Unsa itong stiffness K? So, i-appeal to pag-memorize. P over the deformation. Eh? So, gine karon is the deformation, axial deformation, that is PL over A times the modulus of elasticity. So, muna itong formula ang atong gamiton. And, pagkuhat ang example, there is a steel wire having a length of 30 feet and that is hanging vertically supporting a load of 550 pounds. Neglect the width of the wire. Determine the required diameter if the stress is not to exceed 20 KSI. So this is an allowable stress. Then total elongation is not also exceeding 0.25 of an inch. Assuming modulus of elasticity to be equal to 29 times 10 to power 6 PSI. Okay. So, it looks somewhat like this. In our solution, okay. So, there is a bar. There is a steel wire, man. Carrying a load of pila, 550 pounds. No? I collected also the given like the length of 30 feet. No? What else? This is an allowable stress. Diba? Ganun, eh? This is the allowable deformation, 0.25 of an inch. Then E, the modulus of elasticity, or what's it called, Young modulus in a unit of PSI. Then what is needed is the required D. Now, since we have two allowables, the allowable stress and the allowable deformation, so we can solve for the value of D. And you are by using the two allowables. So, possibly doon na kayo duha ka value sa D. Na? So, ari ko na itong magsugod sa stress. What is the formula for stress if we consider? Stress, if you define, is sa force over area. Itong una na itong i-discuss. Eh? Okay, so it is there where ang imong area mag-involve o kung sa diameter sa imong section. The section looks like this. Now, okay, circular. Minsan mag-diameter. Okay, so in the stress formula, okay, P over A, we are given a stress of pila, allowable, 22 KSI, 22,000, pareho na nag pila, 22,000 pounds per square inch. So we substitute value. This is your P, and this is the stress in a unit of, okay, kips man siya, it's good as 20,000 pounds per square inch. I express it in terms of pounds. Why? Because the load is in pounds. So, if I have P here, correct? So, 550 pounds. Area is pi d squared over 4. So, pound will be out, correct? Okay, so what is left as the unknown is d squared. That is why, if that's d squared, the unit nga mahabilin sa dana would be on sa doon na unit which is in inch squared. Okay, so if you simplify this, no? Kung ato nang i-simplify, no? So, mo-arrive ka na kung sa, mo-arrive ka na value sa D. No? So, kamo na, ikaw na simplify, no? Sa Arrows Band Algebra, kayo, no? Ako tali makalkyo mga yan. Sa ito, shit, solve, I know. Pero, I solve that. In kay calculator, gamita, you will arrive with this, no? Or you have to go with the process of simplification if you like, no? So, kanang 4, ato mo na dito. Yeah? So, kaning imong n squared, no? Denominator, ma-associated manito nandiyan. So, ato na dito. You multiply by n squared, okay? So, it's d squared. So, extract the square root. Then, you obtain this as the value. Pero, dili ta mo conclude diritso nga muna na yung answer. Because there is still another allowable, which is, kini, deformation. So, from the deformation, allowable deformation, no? So, the formula is PL over AE. Okay? So, deformation, if you substitute, we have a value of 0.25 inch there. Then, your P, mo man imong P, pounds man eh, there. Then, ang ato ang length is in feet, no? So, inches man eh, or inch. So, dapat ma-inches na siya dito, correct? Okay, so, para magpariho itong unit. So, that is why I convert this to a unit and inches. One foot is equal to pila, 12 inches. So, foot will be out. So, this is now a unit of an inch. No? Okay. So, if you have an area, area of a circle, di ba? Kana? Area of a circle man eh, di ba? So, kana? Area of a circle. Then, modulus of elasticity. So, na nagpariho na itong unit, pounds. So, pounds will be out. Di ba? Inches will be removed. So, what is left is in squared for your d squared. So, if you simplify this, you also have the value of your d. The d will come out as 0.186. Now, which of the two will you use? No? If, ngayon siya, determine the required diameter, which diameter will you use? The smaller one or the bigger one? Mga dimension gani imong kuhaon to make it safe, no? Ari ka pa doong sa unsa? Ari ka pa doong sa mas dako nga value. Pero gload gani, ato ka pa doong sa mas gamay nga value. To make it safer, no? Kinahanglan safe imuhang body. So, on this case, the answer is the bigger one. So, use the 0.186 of an inch being the safe value. So, ato ni mo kuhaon sa bigger. So, mga dimensions, ito yung kong ingon. Kung dimension gani, ato ka sa mas dako nga value. Kaya kung pananglit kini, kani imong gamiton, this is safe for stress, na? Pero ari ka sa deformation, imo ning ibutang nga denominator dire, mas gamay gani imong denominator. So ato pa mas dako imong value ma-arrive ini. So kun mas dako, posible manobra ka ini. Correct? Okay, kun ang imong denominator kuno gamay, mas ato kun gamay og ubos, dako na og value imong fraction. So kun mas dako og value imong fraction, posible nga kana siya will be exceeded. So it would not be safe if you will be using the smaller one. Pananglit kini, mas dako man eh, nga value. Imong gamiton dire eh. So, 550 over this. So, dili ni mo lampas in eh. Kay kung safe siya ining mas gamay nga divisor, labi na kung imong padakoon dire imong denominator. So, in number over a bigger value, so sa ato pa, muproduce siya value nga much smaller than this. So, kung mas gamay in eh, it would be safe. Kaya nga naman, ingon mga stress is less than or equal to. Okay? So, sa ito, dimension, pero madali, adto ka sa mas dako nga value. Pero glued gani, adto ka sa mas gamay nga value. Okay? Gets mo? Okay, so murag taas-taas naman ito, no? Ato sa nang hunungon o gantong padayunon on the next video, pero ato na yung sunuron na yun, na? Pero ato lang putlon para dilita madugay o upload, na? So, thank you for watching. Yung kinahalisod na sa imong dugha, na? Kinahanglan imo ng subton o maayo, no? Ang concept ganina, o karon nagsugod-sugod na tawag solve sa problem. We are actually applying what formula? We are actually applying the formula for deformation. So, kini, dili ni siya bago because this is an application of the simple stress, no? So, axial. Because ang atong Hooke's law, atong i-apply with the axial deformation. Okay? So, this is also an axial stress. Okay? So, that's all.